We need to know the dimensions of all the physical quantities involved in our models. Well, that seems like a lot of work. Fortunately, it is not so bad at all. There are only a few basic dimensions, and all the others can be expressed in terms of those basic dimensions. So, what are those basic dimensions, and how can you find the dimensions of the other quantities in terms of those basic dimensions? That is what you will learn in this video. So, for our mechanical problems, actually, for most of the cases, three basic dimensions are already enough. For example, we have the dimension of length with a symbol L, and usually as units m meters. Second, mass, symbol m with kilogram, and third, time, symbol t in second. So those are easy to remember, of course. And then we can see how we can derive other dimensions from those. For example, if you have areas, then the dimension is just L squared. And similarly, if you're talking about volume, your dimension is just L cubed, so you'll get it already from this one. If you're talking about velocity, you have the rate of change of the distance divided by the time. So your velocity will get us as a basic dimension L over t, and we already had a t. And similarly for acceleration, you get as basic dimension L over t squared. So you see, with only those three basic dimensions, we already got four more, four important ones. And now we can combine with, for example, mass. If you look at mass density, it's the amount of mass per volume, so m over L cubed. The basic dimension of force, take for example Newton's law, force equals mass times acceleration, and we had already the acceleration and we had already the mass, so there you have the force. And for pressure is force per area. You have your force, you have your area, so there you have your basic dimension of pressure. So you see, with only three basic dimensions, you can find the dimensions of a lot of other quantities as well. What about equations? How can you find the dimensions, for example, of this C over here? If you have frictional force proportional to velocity, what would be the dimension of this proportionality constant C? We always use this notation here. The dimension of V between those brackets like this equals L over T. Now, we can use this to find the dimension of C. We have the dimension of the left-hand side, which is a force, so it is ML over T squared. And on the right-hand side, dimension of minus C times V, the dimension of a number that's dimensionless, so the minus one, we don't have a dimension there. So this becomes the dimension of C times the dimension of V. So we can solve for the dimension of C by solving this equation. And you'll see that the dimension of C equals mass over time. So in this way, you can always figure out what the dimensions of all your constants should be. Now, let's do a second example. Take another friction force proportional to V squared. So well-known friction force equals 1/2 rho times CD times A times V squared, where rho is density of the fluid. CD is a proportionality constant, A is area, and V is velocity. So we know all dimension except for the dimension of CD over there. So let's see. Dimension on the left is again 4, so ML over T squared. Dimension of, we get a dimension of 1/2, which is dimensionless. We get a rho, which is M over L cubed. We get a known dimension of CD. We get the dimension of the area, L squared. And we have a V squared, so we get an L over T squared, so an L squared over T squared. And if you then compute what the dimension of CD is, you see that the dimension of CD is just 1. And that means that actually our CD is dimensionless. So if the dimension of some constant is 1, that's really nice, because that means that we have a so-called dimensionless quantity, a dimensionless constant.